So, hi everyone, how are you all? I hope all of you are doing good in these tough times of COVID and Omicron viruses that are spreading around, right? So today I am back with another bang, that is another bang on topic, that is practical organic chemistry. Right now we were studying organic chemistry till now. We have studied many things about organic chemistry, but this is something different, right? What is this chapter? What is practical organic chemistry? Right now we were studying about the reactions, which type of reactions, how is the formation of alkanes, alkenes, alkyl halides, ketones, functional groups, everything we were studying. But now we just considered what is this use of this studying of this organic chemistry, what is the use of this chemistry, right? So that is the reason this practical organic chemistry chapter was introduced. In this chapter we are going to study many things, that how we can use that part which we studied in the organic chemistry, the theory part, how we can implement that in our daily lives and what are the uses of that, right? So on that note, let us start. In this video I will give you a brief overview of the chapter which we will be what things we will be covering. I'll be telling you that. Then we will be having our main lecture where we'll be discussing each and everything in detail, right? So let us move forward. And first of all, I just want to ask you, how is the quality of the broadcast? That is, if you can see me properly and if you can hear me properly as well. That is, you can rate it from 1 to 10. That is 1 for the worst and 10 for the best, right? So after you rate, then I just want to know, how is the preparation going on? How is your preparation going on? That is, you can rate it from 1, 2 and 3 levels. 1 for the worst, that is that you are not that confident in your level of preparation. 2 is mild, that neither you are happy nor you are too sad about your preparation. 3 is you are really, really happy. You are able to solve a huge amount of questions in a short amount of time. For example, in your JE mains this year, which is coming near, that you have to solve 75 questions in 3 hours, right? And it will be a total 300 marks of a test. So are you able to solve 75 questions sitting 3 hours at a place without standing up, without taking any breaks? Are you giving mock test and you are you can say scoring really, really well in that? So you can just rate it at level 3, right? So we will move forward. And I'm just giving you a brief overview of what is practical organic chemistry. So basically, in practical organic chemistry, what we do is we do qualitative analysis of organic and inorganic compounds too. Qualitative analysis of organic and, one second, let me change the pen. Right. So we do the qualitative analysis of organic and inorganic compounds. Inorganic compound. Right. So what is the qualitative analysis? What is qualitative analysis? Basically, we detect, this is used to detect, we detect nitrogen, halogens, sulfur. For example, if we are given an organic compound, this is a organic compound, so there must be a composition of this organic compound, right? So for example, this organic compounds contains several elements. For example, carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, chlorine, etc. We don't know what is actually present. What is actually present? Right. So we don't know what is actually present in this organic compound. Right. We have to detect. We have to detect the presence of the elements of different types of elements present. Different types of elements present. Right. For example, you can see nitrogen. We can detect the presence of nitrogen. Is nitrogen present in this organic compound? How can we check that? How to detect the presence of a halogen? Is there a halogen present? What is halogen? We denote it by X. And what can be halogens? Chlorine, bromine, iodine, right? Electronegative elements. These are halogen. Is any halogen present in this organic compound? If yes, then how can we check that? What is the proof, right? Sulfur. Is sulfur present in this organic compound? This is the use of practical organic chemistry. So what do we do in this? So for example, in the case of organic compounds, when we do qualitative analysis of organic compounds, there is a thing known as sodium extract. Sodium extract. Right. What is basically sodium extract? So what we know about sodium, we know a simple thing that sodium is used in a common salt, NaCl. Such that in common salt also, many substances, sodium is present. So what is sodium extract? We basically react sodium. With some aqueous solutions or compounds. Which fuses together. They fuse together with sodium. There can be metals can be there, many things can be there, right? It fuses and it forms sodium extract. So it can be this sodium, where can we react with sodium? There can be present NaCl can be there, right? There can be Na2S can be there, right? NaCNS can be there. These compounds can be used for the formation of sodium extract. These compounds can be used for formation of sodium extract. So when we have the sodium extract, we just react it with organic compounds, and different types of reactions can be there when there will be different types of elements present. For example, there is a compound, organic compound, which contains nitrogen in it, right? Then we react it with sodium extract, and there will be some reaction, there will be some particular compounds which will be giving us the proof that yes, nitrogen was present in it, right? So this is about practical organic chemistry. We will study it in detail. We will study detection of each element in different types of reactions in this practical organic chemistry in our coming lecture, right? So next what we will be studying is test for anions, that if this carbonate is present, right? For example, an organic compound is there. Again, the same thing will be happening, that for example, any organic compound is present or not. Let us take an organic compound. Right. So there can be an organic compound, and it can contain either carbonates, sulfates, sulfides, acetate, CH3COO-. It can be a carboxylic acid as well, right? So there can be many things, right? There can be thiosulfates. There can be, these are all again halogens present, right? So what is actually happening? These things are present in an organic compound, right? So if, for example, there is an organic compound and carbonate is present in it, we have to detect that if is carbonate present in it. So for example, let us take the case of carbonate ion, right? Let us take a carbonate ion. What does the carbonate iron react with, right? So if we react carbonate ion with two H plus ions, that is, we can use a acid here. What will actually happen? There will be evolution of CO2 gas plus water formation will be there, right? So we can use it. We can use this equation. How can we use this equation? What will actually happen? There will be an organic compound containing CO3 minus. This is a organic compound containing what? CO3 2 minus. What will we actually do? We react it with the acid. What will actually happen? There will be some products plus there will be a formation of CO2 gas will be evolved from it and water formation will be there. So when we will see that this CO2 gas is being evolved, this will be a proof. This will be a proof of CO3 2 minus presence. Right. So this will be a proof that yes, CO3 2 minus is present. This was just one example of how we can detect an ion in an organic compound. So this is basically practical organic chemistry all about, right? So we can detect sulfides, we can detect many things. Then what is this? This is the test for cations, that how if there are cations present. In this example, I've told you about the test for anions, right? How we can detect anions? Each and every anion will be having a separate reaction. There will be a reaction in detail, right? And then we will move forward. Then we will move on to anion. Right now, I am giving you just a brief overview of the chapter and how what we are going to study in our lecture today, right? So when we will cover the cations, when we will cover the anions, we will move on to cations now, right? What is the test for cations? Right now, I think you are able to get what we are actually doing, that if and right now this will be always already the same case. What will be actually happening here? If any cation is present in an organic compound, for example, group 1 cations, that is lead, silver, that is mercury. If any mercury is present in an organic compound, right, we will react it with something and we will get some products, right? And if that products will be exactly same in the test for a mercury, then we will, you can say, guarantee that yes, mercury was present in this organic compound or in inorganic compound too. For example, you can note down that PbCl2, this lead chloride, PbCl2 gives a yellow PPT, gives, this is one example for cations, right? PbCl2 gives a yellow PPT with what? K2CrO4. This will be the reactant, and when we react it with PbCl2, it gives us a yellow PPT, which is insoluble in acetic acid. What is acetic acid? CH3COOH, right? So what is actually happening? Yellow PPT can be given out by many substances, many compounds, but this yellow PPT is insoluble in an acetic acid. So for example, there will be an organic compound containing Pb in it or PbCl2 in it, right? What we will do? We will react it with what? K2CrO4. What we will actually get? We will get a yellow PPT, right? What we will actually do? We will try to dissolve in acetic acid. If it was indissoluble, indissolvable. If it was indissolvable, then what we will do? We will determine that yes, PbCl2 was present in this organic compound, right? I hope all of you got that. So these all things were we will be covering in the coming lecture. So I hope to see you soon. We will cover each and everything in detail. Till then, keep studying. Bye bye.